Now a sad story, really sad for me, others too perhaps, who grew up here. When you watch the local news and during the dinner hour at 11 p.m., Channel 5 didn't have any news. So the news that really mattered was on Channel 7, Channel 4, Channel 2. The big news, the KNXT broadcast, was massive. Jerry Dunphy, you remember. And you might remember on Channel 2 or Channel 4, David Sheehan. David was the entertainment editor at both stations, and he was the first, the very first, to report on entertainment and review movies and television shows on the air. And if you'll forgive me, if you're 10 or 12-year-old Sammy Rubin watching this from home, you think this man, David Sheehan, has the greatest job in the world. And when there was a big story, a story about the culture, David wouldn't just talk about it with his friends. He'd talk about it. He'd report about it on television.
I went to check it out. The manager of the National Theater in Westwood says that there indeed are at least a dozen people who faint or become ill during every showing. But The Exorcist is still drawing sellout houses for every performance, complete with lines around the block. I spent an evening in the lobby just to see if people really do come stumbling out in the middle of the picture, as reported. They did, so I asked them why.
Do you remember what particular scene it was that...
When she was in a room, the doctors came in, and she was, when I guess it was when she was talking the devil's voice.
This is all we're talking about at the Westwood Elementary Schoolyard, and then there's David Sheehan reporting about it on television. There was a lot more to David Sheehan. He was a novelist. He was a musical theater producer working with greats like Bob Fosse. And long before Tom Hanks was a KTLA Morning News viewer, he knew he had arrived as he sat down with David Sheehan.
When you see something like this, Tom, terrific.
Well, they got to put something up there.
I mean, what? I was trying to imagine if it was me and it said, David the Dynamic.
It would say Dave Dynamic. Wouldn't it say that?
Yeah, maybe. But it didn't. It said, Tom, terrific. What's that do to you?
Well, I think, oh, look, they put Tom Cruise on the cover of Vanity. Oh, no. Oh, wait. No. Oh, that's me. Oh, son of a gun. Son of a gun.
A few other great David Sheehan stories. A single David Sheehan was quite the ladies' man and once panned a movie, and the studio complained that he shouldn't have panned the movie because he was in a screening room necking with the leading lady of the very same movie.
Well, oh, golly.
David was a great tennis player. In his Sunday morning tennis matches, every star you can think of, Warren Beatty among them, were legendary. And then there was a time when being a star, as David Sheehan was in local television, was an extraordinarily lucrative proposition. At the height of his career, David made well over $1 million a year, and this was decades ago. So when I got to meet the man I had watched and admired for years at one of these movie press junkets, my first, and he was so nice and so welcoming, and I had just started, and he could not have been kinder. You'll love this job, David Sheehan told me, and he was right, and this job would have never even occurred to me, wouldn't have existed, if not for the man who pioneered it. David has died. He was 82 years of age. Active to the end, some of his interview specials stream on Amazon. There's a retired group of local broadcasters, news writers, and producers called the News Geezers. David was very active with that group as well. He leaves behind three children and a tremendous amount of admiration and affection.